keep وهذه الوليمة أمر مستحب تزكمن تهاف بالسهل. قال عليه الصلاة والسلام: أولم ولو بفات. هذا banquet even if it was with one feet. So it is a recommended method to do this banquet after marriage. لكن بأي شيء أولم من الطعام الناس. Even if the food he offered was less than that, then it is a valid walima and the sunnah is satisfied. With any food that he has at the banquet, it is valid. From here we know that if you were invited to a wedding where they have some cake, even if it was just some cake, then this is a wedding banquet. And there are judgments related to that, and we'll speak about it. النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام أولم على زينب بنت جحش بشات. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام had a banquet for Zainab, the daughter of Jahash, with one feet. أما على صفية فأولم بالزويق وتمره. As for when he married Lady Safiya رضي الله عنها, the banquet was made with زويق and dates. Sawil is the body, you know, the body, sha'ir. Al-sha'ir is a humnifa wa dukha. If it was roasted and then it was crushed, this is a sawil. So with the banquet, the Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam, he made awla ala safiya bi sawil wa tamlim. This sawil, which is roasted, crushed body, nowadays, if you went to a wedding and you saw a body at the buffet, or if you went to a buffet, mashallah, and this is, subhanallah, what I do is. It is very refreshing to see someone who works according to what he says. Remember when I asked you if you ever had a brother and other boy? Once we were with Sheikh Muhammad Sulaiman, and I spoke with you about. And he was reading something, it was in Ramadan, and he had long sessions. So from the morning till Iftar, then after Iftar till before the Fajr time. And at Iftar, he said, "Amri need food." And we were like a group of people who are considered almost as mashayikh, you know, we all teach. And he prepared the food in one room, he wouldn't let us see it. And then it was the start time, and we went to that room, we found plates with other oil and some dirt. And I can tell you about the look at faces on some people. They were like, seriously? Because subhanAllah, we are very distant from this. For the walima, it is better if he can afford it to have a sheep. You know, but if he can't afford it, then let him offer whatever he can afford. Even if it was some dates or a piece of a cake made at home. And subhanAllah, that night I remember we ate and then we kept going till before dawn. Had we eaten like we usually eat, we would have not been able to do that. You know this, what do you call it, food and the coma after the food. Judgment among the banquets. There is Because the one who فهو دعي طمعا في ذلك. هذا أيضا لا يجب عليه الإجابة. If one was invited because he has a prestigious place and status, and this is why he was invited, because some people they would do, they would be like, oh, this person came to my wedding. Then also he is not obligated to answer or to go to this
إن كان خصوصاً الدعوة عليه.
Thank you. الله تبارك وتعالى. When we were willing to compromise on some days, whether it was your wedding day, your graduation day, the day when you got sick and you had an operation at the hospital, when you were willing to compromise on these days, then it is feared that it will compromise on other days. Some people, they compromise when they are very happy, like at the wedding. Some people, they compromise when they are very sick. And they use the prayer, for example, on that day. You need to remember that the devil keeps trying to misguide the person. And the day when you die, it is mostly it will be the hardest day in your life. You will have faith you've never been through before. And you know what they say about the state, the situation of the person who is dying. And the devil, he tries to take advantage of that. We all know how he tries to tell some people, I will give you this drink if you worship me, or something else. When you are willing, or you are used to compromise when you are sick, you're used to compromise when you need money, you're used to compromise when you are happy, then you might find yourself compromising on that day. The one who fights oneself on these days. When something else happened on another day, he would be like, on my wedding day I didn't do this, now I will do it. When I was sick I didn't do this, now I will do it, I do not accept to do it now. فهنا يوم الأفضل واحد, here we test the patience. When you are happy and you want to look beautiful, are you willing to compromise on the boundaries you know that are set and you are not allowed to تتخطينا to cross? Have you seen someone dying? Have you seen someone dying? Yes. I know it doesn't happen with all the people. There is subhanAllah some kind of the awareness you see in their eyes is something you don't see anywhere else. Because it would be like, okay, this is the end. You know, now I'm moving to a place where I need love. I don't have enough time now to do this and this and this. And you see this look on the face, the awareness they have, that even if you told them something they used to care a lot before about, it wouldn't matter to them. SubhanAllah, I remember my mom, rahimahullah, when she was dying, and you know, we tried to cheer the person up or later, and I was telling her, oh, my sister is calling from Saudi Arabia, and she's I did this and this, we got this and this, and someone else, the one who could have this awareness, this is it, khalas. Try to remember this time when you think about the wedding day or your baby is crying and he wants that toy and you are not allowed to do this, for example, or someone hurt you and you want to take revenge, or yani, the list goes on. When you put this day in comparison with the other days, it would shrink. The wedding day would be just another day when you are supposed to be a wise person. This is why ينبغي التنبه إلى أن لا يقع الواحد في المحرمات في ذلك اليوم. One should be very careful not to be committing sins on that day. مما يحصل كثيرا من الأشياء في ذلك اليوم التي توقع في المعصية هي تشبه بالكفار. Among the things that some people do on that day is doing things that are not permissible for Muslims to do, such as doing things that are the habit of non-Muslims. You know that the Muslims are not allowed to do things that are the habit of non-believers. لكن الآن انتشر كثير من الأشياء التي هي من عادات الكفار. Now many things that are done in the weddings are not among the traditions of Muslims. So we need to be careful. Like, you know, the bow tie? The bow tie. This is not something Muslims used to wear. As an adult, you prefer. You're not allowed to wear it. So dancing. They dance slowly. This is not from what Muslims used to do. Throwing the bouquet. This is not that, what Muslims used to do. So Muslims are not allowed to do this. They are allowed to do many fun things, but they are not allowed to do this.
I was told about a man in Lebanon.
Israel. After the dinner, he told the people, okay, everyone, flip your plate. And there was a golden coin for each guest on the back of the plate. You know what some people started saying? Oh, come on, it's very good. He could have put two. This is what they said. So he was like, oh, I'm putting a golden coin. And they were like, come on. He can put two. So don't waste your time trying to please everyone. Please with God, and you do just fine. Obey your God. Obey.
You were invited and you live far away, and it might be expensive or difficult for you to travel for a wedding.
To travel? Is that kind of like that the summer? The man, although he is her husband, he is not obligated to support. congregation that he is talking to us. واضح؟ فعندما يحصل مجرد العقد بمجرد هذا لا يجب عليه نظرهما. Merely doing the contract, it does not make it obligatory upon him to support him. لكن عندما تصير في بيته تسلم إليه هنا يجب عليه نظرهما. When he moves to his place, for example, he is obligated to support him.
يتزوج إلا أن يذوقها ثم يطلقها وتتزوج
وبين أيضا أن الرجل له حق عظيم على زوجته. And also the Islam taught us that the man has a great light on his wife. كما يظهر من قول النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام. لو كنت آمرا أحدا أن يسجد لأحد لأمرت المرأة أن تسجد لزوجها. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام he said, if I were to order anyone to prostrate to anyone, I would have ordered the woman to prostrate to her husband. The woman is not ordered to prostrate to her husband, but he said, if I were to order anyone to prostrate to anyone, I would have ordered the woman to prostrate to her husband. فإذا المرأة لها حقوق والرجل له حقوق. المرأة عليها واجبات والرجل عليه واجبات. Women have rights and men have rights. Women are obligated of certain matters and men are too. الشرع لم يظلم الرجل ولم يظلم المرأة. Religion was not, is not unjust to the man and is not unjust to the woman. والزوجان مطلوب أن يتذكرا دائما أنهما هدف للبيس. The married couple, they should always remember that they are a target for the devil. يحب أن يوجع بينهما. The devil likes to make them fight and actually separate. وضرت الحديث إن إبليس يضع عرشه على الماء. It was narrated in the hadith that the devil places his throne on the water. ثم يبعث سراياه يرسل جنوده. Then he sends his demons out. قال عليه الصلاة والسلام فأدناه منه منزلة أعظمه فتنة. The one who is closest to him is the one who causes the biggest sedition. قال يجيء أحده فيقول فعلت كذا وكذا. One of them would come, one of the demons would come, and he would say, I did so and so. And Iblis would not be pleased with justice. So he would do, you didn't, he would say, you didn't do anything. فيقول Iblis ما فعلت شيئا. Because he wants more. حتى يجيء واحد فيقول ما تركته حتى خلقت بينه وبين امرأته. Until one of the demons he would come and say, I did not leave him until I said, until I broke him and his wife apart. الشيطان يحاول يبقى حتى يصل إلى هذا. شايفين احنا عم يتخانقوا؟ Have you seen two couples who are, a couple who are fighting? They would be like, you feel that there's something boiling. And he would try to go outside and then she would follow him. He would feel, I want to say this work. Because this is the devil. He wants to reach that place where you are separated. And one should always stop and say, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. ذاك يأتي يقول ما تركته. I did not leave him alone until I broke him and his wife apart. فيدنيه إبليس. إبليس رأس الكفر. يدنيه ويلتزمه. المرة مبسوط فيه. ويقول له نعم أنت. Iblis then, he would be so pleased with him, he would bring him closer and hug him and say, you are so good. Because he was able to do what Iblis wants, which is separating him and his wife. لذلك الواحد لابد أن يكون على حذر. One should be careful. Again, having the tranquility in marriage, this is something essential. But this is something that you need to work for. When two people are married, you know, someone who had a family and a certain way of thinking and another person, and they are now in the same place. There are many differences. But when we both know the boundaries, it becomes easier. There are very So merely with wearing a white dress, a wedding day, and a مؤثر معناه ذكر له. فإذا ذكر أن المحضر مؤثر فهذا يكون محضر مؤثرا، وإلا يكون حالا. معناه إذا ذكر الحلول أو أطلق لم يذكر حلول ولا تأثير يكون مؤثرا. فمثلا إذا قال زوجتك ابنتي على مهر قدره 100,000، هيدا حال وسكر، هيدا حال. إذا قال زوجتك ابنتي على مهر قدره 100,000 حالا، هيدا حال. فإذا سواء نص على الحلول أو أطلق يكون حالا. حتى يكون مؤثر بده يكون ذكر الأسر مهر مؤثر إلى 10 سنين مثلا. So, if we want to determine if the bridal payment was due immediately or it was delayed, we will look at the contract, what was said in the marriage contract. If it was said, mentioned specifically that it is delayed, then it is delayed. Can you give the example?
Yes, we found that she said it was if they knew that the man was said to be, I married you for the amount of such and such to be paid after 10 years.
However, if he didn't mention that it is postponed, he said,
if they just mentioned what the matter was and they didn't mention a specific delayed due date, then that bridal payment would be due immediately.
طيب،
نعم.
خير الصداقة أي صدق. خير الصداقة أي صدق. الأحسن أن يكون المهر خفيفا. say that. He can say it's because Syria, the man, if he didn't pay it, it's a debt. The man would be owing his wife this amount. So just like if someone owes you money, you might say, okay, I don't want it anymore from you. Yes, فقد أخذها وصار عندي، فلا تنسى حقوقها وإن كان لك حقوقها. وبالنسبة للمرأة كذلك، هذا الرجل يكون صار أعظم الناس حقا عليك يا خير من كل الناس في الأرض. هذا من كل أقاربك هذا أعظم الناس حقا عليك. على كل واحد أن يكون منصفا لنفسه، ومن لم يلتزم بالأحكام الشرعية فهذا فضلا عن مخاطرته في أمر آخرته فغالبا لا يكون سعيدا في دنياه فيكون خسر هذا وخسر هذا. فالكل عليه أن ينتبه لهذا.
Losing